I really struggled with the still pictures of this one. This is, I suspect we're looking at Braunheit here, this section here. But now, just let me see if I can, there we go. That's more like it. This one really is best enjoyed when held in hand. There you can see the cubic formation of the Braunheit. This is not a fracture zone. This is actually a crystalline surface. I struggled a little bit to get it out in the still pictures. Associated with this material would be ettringite, the white, the yellow, and then the white material could very well be some, in my estimation, perhaps gypsum. I don't see any other associations. At times I do find what appears to be guardafoyet, etc. There, the main focus, of course, of this specimen is this particular section. And it almost, the camera makes it almost look synthetic. It's a lovely silver metallic. Let's go around the back. That would be the matrix. So it's a pretty solid manganese matrix. I'd imagine a pretty high-grade ore because the relative weight of this is quite heavy. Quite lovely. All the way from South Africa, Kalahari manganese fields in the northern Cape of South Africa. Quite lovely. Let me just zoom in on that section. There we have it. And those would be all these almost blocky crystals. Now the Braunheit in this case would be very similar to the Bixbeite. Makes little cubes which stack on top of each other, leading into a termination. The Bixbeite from this deposit would almost have a little pattern on the faces, and I don't see any patterning on these faces, so that's why I'm going with Braunheit on this piece.